It is Doctors Day today, and from the entire team at NDTV, we salute all those frontline heroes who are leading the fight for good health amid very difficult circumstances at the moment. And we have some frontline doctors, healthcare workers joining us on the broadcast. Dr. Saswati Sinha, Internal Medicine and Critical Care, joins us from Kolkata. We have Dr. Fameer CK, General Secretary of the AIIMS Nurses Union, also joining us from the National Capital. Thank you very much for being with us. Wish you a very happy Doctors' Day. And I want to begin by thanking you, you know, on behalf of the entire country for your selfless service at a very, very difficult time. Dr. Saswati, if I can sort of begin by asking you, you know, what's this last one and a half years of a pandemic been like for you personally?
Thank you for having me on the show. Thank you for your wishes. This last 15 months, in fact, has been the most unprecedented scenario in my 20-year-long career as an intensive care professional. Completely, you know, there have been scenarios where there have been so much of anguish, so much of despair, so much of helplessness at times. Although these have been punctuated by certain good days when we've been able to send very sick patients and reunite them with their families.
Yes.
So it's been very tough.
Yes, I'm sure. I mean, one can't even imagine. We've been reporting on these stories, but, you know, doctors like yourselves have actually been living it on a daily basis. Fameer, if I can come to you, you know, it's doctors, nurses, sanitization workers, frontline workers, you know, everyone who's really put themselves on the line in the interest of the larger public good, in the interest of providing healthcare at a very difficult time. You know, what's it been like for nurses? You know, often behind the lines, unsung heroes.
Hello.
Yes, can you hear me?
Yeah, well, first of all, I would like to thank you, NDTV2, for giving me an opportunity to talk regarding the Doctors' Day. So I just want to wish all the doctors a happy Doctors' Day. And it's you can say that there is a day we are remembering our doctors, the frontline warriors. We can see that usually no one cares about a doctor as a human. Always people demand much from them, doctors. They never bother whether they are having a family or whether they are a human. Really, it's, we have to thank all the doctors who are tirelessly working for our country. Especially during this pandemic time. Being a nurse, I can see we are just very near to the nurse, doctors, and how they are struggling for our country, for the patients, by sacrificing their personal life, family, and how they are doing good for the community and the society,
yes.
Or the way they are. But unfortunately, we can see that people won't count or they are not seeing the doctors as humans, but they are demanding much more from them. So that's a pathetic situation. Yeah.
You know, I think it's very important that we acknowledge, Dr. Sinha, just how difficult this year has been for doctors who, you know, might have become superheroes in this last one and a half years of fighting the COVID-19 pandemic, but are also very human at the end of the day. You know, a lot of doctors like yourselves have made several personal sacrifices during this time. Tell us a little bit about how this year has been for you personally.
Personally, this year has completely changed my life as an individual on my personal front. My parents live in the same city, just about 10 kilometers from where I live. I did not meet them for 7 months. And even now when I go, it's a sense of fear. I'm always masked up, sitting a few, several meters away from them. Every night when I come back home, I have sort of isolated myself from the rest of the people. It's very difficult, completely cut off from all kind of social,
yes,
interactions. And every day, the fear of bringing an infection home is still there.
Right. And what about you, Fameer? We know that there are a lot of nurses who, you know, work in city hospitals, for instance, but they come from far-flung areas. And one has heard stories of nurses who haven't returned home for several months on end. They haven't met their families, their parents, or, you know, in some cases, haven't even seen their children.
Yeah, ma'am. It's a tough situation, and it's the other side of the coin. You can see that many of the nurses, as madam said, they are not seeing their family. Many a times it happens that they are not able to go to a family. They are hit also because of the fear of infect, or some maybe because of some. And really sacrificing our personal life,
yes.
Especially the second wave, can see that we have to the home, all the vacations, everything,
yes.
And everyone is struggling for entire nation.
But, you know, Dr. Sinha, despite the personal sacrifices that you all make on a daily basis, what keeps you going? What keeps you motivated? You know, the pandemic hasn't ended. We may have a temporary relief at the moment with cases down, but there is anticipation, talk of a third wave. What keeps you motivated? What keeps you going despite all the hardships that you face professionally and personally?
See, basically, when you take up a job of a doctor or a nurse, for that matter, and especially if you're dealing with intensive care, this has been multiplied several times in magnitude. But each time you can send a very critical patient back home, reunite them with their families, I think this is what gives us the biggest joy.
Right. So it is in a certain sense job, yeah, satisfaction that really keeps you motivated. Fameer, what about you? You know, what keeps you going? What keeps nurses going? I mean, you know, often, like you said, there are so many nurses who come from far-flung areas in the country. They haven't gone back home, especially, you know, the second wave of COVID. Seeing people, serving people on a daily basis, many of whom, especially in the second wave, didn't actually make it. What keeps you motivated? What keeps you going?
Definitely, madam, as we see that we can see the patients at our ward. They are helpless. They really need our help. And today, I just completed my call and I'm here for this. Even though the second wave comes to an end or is going out, but still we are having hospitals. We want to take care of them. And if they are able to come back to the normal life, that's the greatest reward that we are getting. And we are getting more pleasure by taking care to a patient. And during this COVID, you can see that entirely the patient is helpless because he's not able to take care of,
yes,
himself. He's able to go to his family. So by talking with them, wow, by giving care, a joy for us, and gives a satisfaction and make us go back to the duty.
Right. So saving lives and seeing patients go back home to their families, recovering, has of course kept you going. I think that's a common sentiment that you both share. But Dr. Sinha, if I can come back to you, you know, how prepared are we both in terms of, you know, infrastructure support and mental health support for healthcare professionals going forward? Because, you know, like I said at the very outset, the fight is not over. This fight continues. And, you know, do you think that we have the resources that we need in order to continue to keep going?
Well, I think the second wave should have given us enough insights into where we went wrong after the end of the first wave. So this is the time, probably, rather than just sitting back and relaxing, I think this is the time to ramp up our infrastructure. The major lack where I feel we are, because all the healthcare workers, the doctors and the nurses, they're absolutely stretched to the hilt in terms of physical and mental health. So I really do not know how the medical manpower is going to be ramped up. So, but still, I think the hospitals need to have a look, have some kind of an insight into how we are going to face the forthcoming waves.
I want to also ask you, Dr. Sinha, about medical students, final year students who've been, inducted into what many say is, literally thrown into the deep end. Do you think this is good? It gives them a head start into dealing with crisis situations at the very outset? Or do you think that, more time and counseling is needed for young students entering the profession and really, like I said, diving into the deep end?
Well, I guess completely, you're absolutely right. So rather than just, exposing them to very difficult situations at the beginning of their career, I would feel that, if our senior colleagues from the other specialties who are not having very busy times during the pandemic situation, like our surgical colleagues or from other specialties, if they could join the medical workforce in order to lend us a hand, to maybe take care of less critically ill patients so that, some amount of relief is there from that end. So that would be better rather than exposing freshers to it.
Right. We also have Dr. Parvez Grant, a managing trustee of the Grant Medical Foundation, joining us from Pune. Thanks, Dr. Grant, for being with us on NDTV.
Good morning, Rishika. How are you?
Happy Doctor's Day to you.
Thank you very much.
And I began this little conversation by thanking doctors like yourselves, your teams, for your, for the sacrifices you make, for the tireless effort and work that you put in on a daily basis. And we were just talking about what keeps doctors going. It's been such a difficult time, both personally and professionally, for several doctors like yourselves. What keeps you motivated? What keeps you going?
See, last year we went through a very difficult period. And the hospital which I have basically got three hospitals in Pune, and I'm running something in the range of 900 beds. So last year, our occupancy went down very badly, and we were down to practically 200 beds in all the hospitals. Now I'm seeing a marked recovery that has taken place, and I'm very happy to announce that from 600 cases of corona, which we had 1 month ago, today, in two of the hospitals, we have zero corona cases. And in one hospital, we have only 8 corona cases. So I think Pune has really conquered corona. I'm now finding that all the other specialties, which over the last 1 year had gone down drastically, like cardiac, cancer, neurosurgery, all these specialties have started now slowly, slowly coming back to normal. So we are practically at normal occupancy. We are at normal functioning in all our three hospitals now. And I'm very happy to say that in Pune, we have really conquered corona at the present moment. Now, I don't know whether we get a third wave, but that's still what we're hoping that we don't get.
Right. But Dr. Grant, are we prepared for a third wave? Because several experts have warned.
We are prepared for a third wave. We are prepared for a third wave. We have kept everything ready. But at the moment, I don't see it coming at all because vaccination has really taken off in the city of Pune.
Yes.
We are now about 15% to 16% vaccinated, the city. And the program is going on at full speed. We are practically vaccinating 1 lakh people a day in the city of Pune.
Hmm.
So hopefully we will not get a third wave. But I don't know what's going to happen in the peripheral areas because at that peripheral areas.
Yes, and I think, because you talk about vaccination, I think that's extremely key as well. And many believe that hopefully the third wave, as in when it comes, won't be as severe as what we saw in the second wave. But speaking of the second wave, Famir, if I can come back to you, dealing with the aftermath of the second wave, a lot of us, as journalists also continue to relive those stories, in our heads, and we've seen those stories, we've reported on them, but you've really lived through them on a daily basis. What's the aftermath of the second wave been like for nurses like yourselves?
Really, it was a tough time we have gone through the second wave because we have put all our efforts to fight the second wave. We can see that all the doctors have canceled their patients. They have put more efforts, more times, clinicals with the patients, less number of days off. They were with the patient. They were trying their level best to fight second. So that's the way we have put ourselves to manage this second wave. Mm-hmm. And you can see that of the speciality, everyone come to the seat. Even the doctors, we can see they have left their speciality.
Yes.
Again, psychiatrists, ophthalmologists, even BDS doctors were with the front.
Yes.
They are fighting for them. Okay. Somehow we managed to overcome the second weekend.
Yes. Well, it's been all hands on deck, no doubt. Dr. Sinha, Famir, Dr. Grant, thank you all very much for sparing your time, being with us on NDTV. And once again, thank you for your selfless service.